Vanakkam, namaste, and blessings to everyone. This is Dr. Bhairavi Balasubramanian, PhD, the Sky Priestess. So, I cannot tell you how many times I've been trying to upload this video, either through lives or some other means, but YouTube is changing its format. And unfortunately, I think that's clashing with my software, and so the videos are getting lost. So, I'm doing this a different way, using the camera on my computer, and so hopefully this should actually work. Maybe it's time to get a new phone. I don't know. So what I wanted to talk to you about is very simple. We are worried about what state the world is heading into. What I can tell you is the great cataclysm that everyone's afraid of is not exactly going to be happening now. Looking at the energy of the alignments for the next few years ahead, I can tell you that there's actually a lot more karmic purging to go through before the world enters into a state where everyone's going to need an underground bunker. But given the trajectory of events and, of course, Bernie Sanders quitting the American presidential race, to me, that says that it's time for us to stop believing in having, you know, those in power actually able, wanting or willing to make a change. Because honestly, I think we've passed the point where we can actually afford that trust. We probably passed that point a few decades ago, to be honest, but this is when it's really hitting mass consciousness. So what I would honestly say about this is that this is the kind of energy which asks us to really look at what we as individuals and a community can do for ourselves. What is the kind of safety net that we can actually create for those who don't have that privilege? For people who don't have enough money to go into an underground bunker, or people who don't have the kind of resources to be taken care of for the rest of their lives. So it's the kind of energy where we actually see people needing to help other people. So this is really where we, I would say, as a whole and a collective, need to realize that it's time to step up. This is not where we need to be looking to someone else to provide us with benefits, but where we actually need to come together in groups and do this for ourselves. I would imagine it akin to creating a safety net all over the planet. And my cat agrees. So this is the kind of energy which asks you to be selective in your team. Who are your team members? Who are the people who share a similar version of view of reality as you? Who are the people who are willing and wanting to come together to go and do things together so that we can create a better world for us all? Okay, I thought Kitty would say hi, but she decided to come in. So what I would say is, in the next 2 weeks, look at the networks, look at the people who have the tools, who have the resources, who have the requirements to make such a vision take off the ground. Now, you're going to have to wait until the end of the year to launch anything anyways, at the very least, August. The reason I say this is because it will literally take that long for Venus to actually finish its whole retrograde shadow motion, da-di-da-di-da. It's got all this stuff going on. So, like I said, I've tried to do this video too many times. I'm going to leave you to the in-depth article which has all of this information anyway. My kitty cat is saying, Mommy, you've been working too hard. So what I would say is use the next 2 weeks to network with the right people. Find the right people who can help you manifest the vision that you want to manifest in this world, and take a few months to work it out. You really need to see that these are not people who are just trying to ride on your coattails or trying to freeload. You need to see if these are people who are actually willing to put in the effort. Because for all their talk, all of this visualization and stuff is not going to feed a hungry child. It's not going to clothe someone who needs clothes. It's not going to save a drowning person from water. The person standing there with the rope is. And so it's really time to be looking at these charitable and altruistic concerns from the planet in a very material sense. And time to write to all those rich people you know who have the resources, and to government to get recognized as an NGO, nonprofit organization or charity or whatever. It's time to start looking at that paperwork. What we also see in this next coming 2 weeks, now this is general advice, you know, for the next few months, but specifically in the next few weeks, especially around the 13th to the 15th, we're going to be seeing incredible volatile triggering with Saturn conjunct Eris and Aries, squared Pluto on the day of its occultation with the moon, and squared Jupiter in Capricorn. This is really where we need to be looking at just what type of energy is coming through the collective and how it is impacting us and how we are being triggered as individuals to respond to it in one way or another. So this is really where we need to look at our personal egos and our own sense of rebellion and how much it wants us to, you know, make us want to butt heads with the establishment. That's not going to work. We're going to see this again, especially once the Sun enters Taurus. As soon as it enters Taurus, it's going to be squaring off with Saturn in Aquarius, and that's also going to be the same energy we see during the new moon. So really, the 19th to the 23rd, we're going to be seeing lots and lots and lots of energy just wanting to clash with the status quo. And whilst that might make your ego feel great, that doesn't help anybody. Before you start any major project, use the next few months to be working not only with your physical team, but your metaphysical team. Work with your guides, work with your angels, work with the beings that are actually watching out for you, and ask them to clear and pave the way forwards. Pave the way forwards so that you can actually do the work that you wanted to do. So this is actually, I would say, an important preliminary to whatever you actually want to do when the time comes to act. Now, in terms of just trying to manage the day-to-day, just trying to manage the energy of, daily boredom or anxiety, sit with spirit, meditate, do things that allow you to deeply process at the back of your mind. Like I do jigsaws for that reason. When I'm doing it, I'm still thinking about and processing and filtering. I'm not just doing things to fill my time. When you do that, you are less able to hear yourself and you are less able to hear the voice of spirit because you're too busy filling in. So I know it's a time where people feel very vulnerable, people feel very uncertain, people feel very just, you know, they feel like, I don't know what to do. But this is exactly when your faith needs to kick in. Every one of us has something to contribute. It may not be money, it may be communication, it may be an idea, it may be manpower, woman power, person power. But whatever it is, this is really where we need to look at our skills and to connect with people who have a similar vision and idea. Playing the victim card will not help anybody. We have to take responsibility for our actions at this time, because it is us who is actually going to do something for those who are the least privileged or who are the least able to. I mean, I know that the government here literally rounded up 1,000 homeless people and put them in camps, basically, to give them food. Not bad camps, but we're going to need to do more, because I can tell you for sure we're going to be seeing more crises in the planet over the next few years. So get out of your own way, get out of your own headspace, listen to spirit and find the right alignments. The same thing applies with relationships. Don't jump into things and commit into things in the name of service, because often it comes from a space of feeling truly inadequate and vulnerable within. Take the time, do your due diligence, vet whatever it is you want to invest into, and really think about it in August. That's what I would want to say with this additional attempt of trying to get this video out. This is the stuff in the nutshell. There's also the article you can look at. And if you can, please do support my work. Those of you who have the resources to do so, join the Tier 23 program, because there is a lot more detail written and in video. For those of you who would prefer giving a one-off contribution, I've also put my PayPal account information at the end of this newsletter. And for those of you who want to work with me in sessions, do so, but only once you've had that chance to tune in. Having said that, that's a wrap. Take care. Very many blessings. Lots and lots and lots of love to all. And cha-cha for now. Bye-bye.